Hi, I'm Sarah.
And I'm Andrea, and we're from Peanut Buttered Blog.
Welcome to our Spoonful of Comfort series. And today we're going to be making chicken, leek, and pancetta individual pot pies. Okay, so I'm going to start by drizzling some of this olive oil into the pan.
So that was garlic-infused olive oil, so it just makes it easy. You don't have to bother with chopping or mixing up any garlic, so it's way easier. And next we're going to put in some pancetta cubes and fry them up.
So what heat are they going on?
I've cranked it up pretty high to do the pancetta, and then once we put the leek and the carrot in, we'll just turn it down to a medium and throw in the carrots and the leeks. You can use any vegetables, actually. I've put in peas before, even some potatoes, whatever you really have to hand.
Are there any vegetables that don't work in this particular pie?
I don't think so. I think you can throw in anything.
If you want to make this at home, you can check the description box for the full list of ingredients. So how long are we going to leave these in for?
Basically until the carrots have softened a little bit. So we'll probably let them cook down for about 5 minutes, but in the meantime, we can get our chicken ready. Okay, so we have some chicken thighs cut up into bite-sized pieces, and we're going to throw them into a freezer bag. You can do this in a bowl, but this is easier, I find, and it's fun because you get to have a bit of a shake. We've got some flour, which will help to thicken the sauce, and some thyme.
And that's fresh thyme?
Yeah, you can use fresh or dried, just lessen it a little bit if it's fresh.
Shake it around.
Have a good, nice shake. Okay, so next we're gonna put in about a tablespoon of butter.
Great.
We can chuck in that chicken out. Flour, everything from the bag goes in.
Try not to get the bag into the pan.
And we're gonna put in the mushrooms now as well.
So it's a really hearty dish for this time of year, especially now it's getting colder.
Yeah.
And all the colours in the pan look great.
You actually feel like it's really healthy as well.
Yeah. The chicken's still a little bit pinky. We're just browning it at the moment, but the cooking will be done in the oven. So that's absolutely fine.
Okay, so we're going to add some chicken stock. And 1 tablespoon of marsala to give it a nice little kick.
And do this without spilling it.
Oh, ah. Nice job.
There we go.
Beautiful. So just give this a nice little stir and let it bubble away for about 10 to 15 minutes, just until the sauce really thickens.
While that's bubbling away, we're gonna work with the pastry. We cheated, so it is bought. We didn't make it, but that doesn't matter, does it?
To be honest, when I come home from work and I'm about to make a pie, I'm not going to be making dough from scratch. Sorry, this is fine. It works perfectly. Just going to roll it out to a couple of millimetres thick.
We just floured the work surface so that it doesn't stick, and we just dusted the rolling pin with a bit of flour too. So I think that's all rolled out fine.
Looking good. Okay, so we're going to just take our individual pie dishes and just cut around so we don't have too much excess pastry. It does not have to be neat. In fact, I really go for the rustic look because it makes life easier.
So you can adapt this recipe for one big pie, but we like individual ones, daily portions.
And it cuts down on the cooking time as well. These only take about 20 minutes, where a big pie would probably take about 40 minutes. Okay, so as you can see, the sauce has thickened up beautifully, so we're ready to put these into our pie dishes. There's going to be a bit of room in between the pastry and the mixture, but that's okay. Okay, so we're just going to add our pastry, put it that way. Just kind of make sure it's all covered. If there's a bit too much, you think, just rip it off a little bit. As I said, going for the rustic look. Okay, so we're just gonna grab some forks. There you go. Yours is neater than mine. Hey! And basically, just to seal the edges, we're just gonna push down just gently with a fork. And I think it looks pretty.
And it's all about the aesthetics.
Absolutely. Just gonna grab one little beaten egg. And just wash over the top, and this will make it really nice and golden. These just need to be popped on a baking tray and put in the oven for 20, 25 minutes or until they're all puffed up and golden. Okay, so we've taken them out of the oven. They're beautiful and golden and perfect looking.
Mine's a little bit more beautiful.
It is. I'll give you that one.
Okay.
Okay, should we crack into one, see how
I
it looks on the
so.
Inside?
I think this is the best bit. Well, that's...
Oh.
That's quite good in a...
Smells amazing.
Okay.
Mm.
That's good.
Good?
It's really good.
We're gonna go enjoy these now.
and we hope to see you soon for more recipes in our series.
Bye.
Bye.